Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger, and today I want to introduce you to projective geometry. It's an old and beautiful subject that has a lot of applications to modern linear algebra, graphics programs, and to hyperbolic and spherical geometries, as we shall see. The subject, as does much of geometry, goes back to the ancient Greeks, to Pappus, who lived 300 years after Christ, and he discovered the following fact, which you can verify by yourself with just a ruler and a pencil. We have two lines, this one and this one. And on the two lines, we choose three points, A, B, and C, and A prime, B prime, and C prime. Where these points are is irrelevant, and what order they're in is irrelevant. We join A to B prime, and B to A prime, and see where those two lines meet. We'll call that point C double prime. So that A, B prime, A prime, B. Then we join A and C prime and A prime, C. Call that intersection B double prime. And finally, we join B prime and C and the B and C prime to get a point A double prime. And Pappus showed that these three points are collinear. They're lie on a line. Now here's a special case. Doesn't matter where these two lines are and where the A, B, C, and A prime, B prime, C prime on them are. In this case, A, B prime, and B, A prime happen to be parallel. And A, C prime, and A prime, C are also parallel. In this case, these intersections actually don't exist, but Pappus' theorem still has some content. It says that the other two set of lines, in this case, the B, C prime, and B prime C lines must also be parallel. So somehow parallel lines meet at infinity in some nebulous way. The second theorem in the subject, and the second most important theorem in the subject, is Desargues' theorem, discovered by a Frenchman who lived in the 17th century and who was perhaps the founder of the modern theory of projective geometry. He discovered that if you have two triangles A, B, C, and A prime, B prime, C prime, which are perspective from a point, then they are perspective from a line. So what does that mean? Well, the two triangles A, B, and C have their three vertices all on these three lines emanating from O. So this line contains A and A prime, this line contains C and C prime, and this line contains B and B prime. That's what we mean by the two triangles are perspective from that point. The conclusion of the theorem is that if you take AB, that side, and the side of the other triangle, A prime, B prime, then you get one intersection point. If you take AC, A prime, C prime, you get another intersection point. And if you take BC and B prime C prime, you get a third intersection point. And those three intersection points are always collinear. So we say that the two triangles A, B, and C and A prime, B prime, C prime are perspective from a point, means equivalently that they are perspective from a line. I really urge you to try it out yourself, draw some example triangles, and with a straight edge, you can verify yourself that no matter what configuration you take, the same lovely relationship will always hold for these intersection points. And the last of our three basic theorems for today concerns the relationship between a quadrangle and a quadrilateral. In projective geometry, we say that four points, say A, B, C, D, form a quadrangle. Four lines form a quadrilateral. So suppose we start with four points forming a quadrilateral, and we'll suppose that no three of them are collinear. Then we can associate to those four points six lines. That's one, that's two, that's three, that's four, that's five, and there's the sixth one. Just the all possible lines through those four points. Now, those six lines intersect in three additional points. So aside from the four points that we started with, We also have a new intersection here, here, and here. Those three new intersections are called the diagonal points of the quadrangle. And the lines through them form a triangle, which we call the diagonal triangle of the original quadrangle. And now something rather interesting happens, because that triangle intersects the lines of the quadrangle in some additional points. So where are those additional points? There's one right here, and 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 we can see one right here, and there will be another one, well, where this line here, the blue one, and this green line here will meet somewhere down here, or perhaps somewhere up there. And these new 6 points form new lines. There's one. There's two. And this one meeting that one at another point of intersection that's off the page. And these two also meeting that additional intersection that's off the page. So we get 4 new lines forming a quadrilateral, which is called the opposite quadrilateral to the quadrangle we started with. Please check it out yourself. Draw some pictures. Next time, we're going to have a look at where projective geometry got its origins from in terms of perspective and the attempt of artists to settle the long-standing question of how do you represent a 3-dimensional picture in a plane, that is, in a picture. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.